Okay guys, welcome back. Today we're going to talk about function macros. So what is a function macro? Well, a function macro is like a regular definition, but you can supply arguments to it. And let's begin by an example. It's a little bit easier than to talk about it. Alright, so let's create something called sayHello.c, and we will include standard IO. I will create a main function which will be quite small. I will just have a char pointer with a name pointing to my name, and then I will have a construction called sayHello, and I will send the name to that construction. Then I will return 0 at the end. Okay, so what can this sayHello thing be? Well, it can be a regular function. Let's begin there. So if it were a function, then it would probably be a void function, because it really doesn't need to return anything. And the name is sayHello, and as an argument it takes a pointer to a string, like this. And this function will just print out a message. That says hello to this argument name, like this. And I usually close my void functions with a return without the value. That's not really necessary. That's just because I like having the same structure to my functions. Okay, so let's compile this one. And if we run it, it works. Okay, so what's the problem with this code? Well, it's a very unnecessary function. And even though it doesn't take many CPU cycles to run this, there is a lot of overhead. It's a very small function. And every function takes up a little bit of overhead. You need to, you have seen my episode about functions. It does need to change some CPU registers, shuffle around some memory, jump around the code, etc. So if we can do this a better way, that would be preferred. So one way would be to just copy this printf line and use it in our main and remove this function entirely. But that would kind of defeat the purpose, because if we made this into a function, that's probably a bit of our code that we plan to reuse a couple of times around the code, and we can't really do that if we don't have a function like this, or something, a construction like this. But that's where the preprocessor and the function macros come in. So we all know already that we can create a constant definition by defining something like what should we take? Flower, and then a string in this case. I'm not sure about the spelling, but something like that. Daffodil. Okay. And we can also use this for other things than strings. So let's say we have a number which is 5, etc. And if we use these constants inside of our code, then the preprocessor, which is a function which runs when you compile something or right ahead before the compilation, it will take this string and look around your code. If it found flower with caps in this case, and copy paste this daffodil string instead of all the flowers. Same with this number, it would put the 5 instead of the flower. So this is a way of, without a lot of overhead, making it easier for the programmer and making the code easier to read. And we can do the same with functions, and that is called function-based macros or function macros. So let's say we want to create a macro instead of the function we had. We can even call it the same. So we define say hello, and then we put a parameter here. So let's say x. So the idea here is that we will replace this x with what the programmer sends as an argument. So in this case we do say hello name, and name will be put instead of this x parameter. And what do we define this as? Well, we want to do the printf where we say hello %s new line. And what should we take as an argument right here? That's right, the x parameter. And we're not ending this line with a semicolon, because we don't do that when we do preprocessor stuff. So if you have a character like this hashtag in the beginning of the line, no semicolon at the end. Okay, so let's try this macro out. And we run it again. Say, and we get hello Jonas. Same as before. So this works very well. And it's quite easy to define those macros. So we do define, and then we give it a name. Then we put the arguments, and this can be several, like x, y, z, etc. We do a space or a tab or something, and then we put what we want it to substitute. So it will substitute this hello, say hello, with this printf stuff, but it will handle the arguments correctly. Okay, so that's one of these macros, but this wasn't a very useful example. It was more of a just an example. But how can we use this in production? Well, one way is a macro which is very commonly used, and it's called the min macro. and it takes two parameters, x and y. Okay, so the min macro works the same way as the CSS function does. You supply it with, let me show you inside of main. Let's do a printf, and let's just output a regular integer value. And we send the min function, and then two integer values. So let's say, for example, 10 and 5. And what this min macro does is it looks at these two parameters, arguments, and it returns the lowest of these two. So in this case, it will return the 5 because it's less than the 10. And this is quite useful in many cases. We can also define the max variant of it. Okay, so how do we define this? Well, we need to do some kind of conditional, right? So we can check which is biggest and return the smaller one. And the easiest way is to do it with a ternary in this case. So let's check if y is less than x. In that case, we will return y, otherwise we return x. And if you're not familiar with ternaries, this is the same as if we were to do... And let's imagine this code in the middle of a regular function body. So if y is less than x, then we return y, else return x. So this code is entirely the same. And it works like this. You give a condition, then you do a question mark, and if this is true, then we return this value, and then a colon, otherwise we return x. And this works both in the macros and elsewhere in your code. It's not specific to the preprocessor or the macros. So let's see if it works. It will print out the 5. Even though we gave the 10 first, it printed the 5 because the 5 is the smallest of these two. And this is a very useful macro and a too small of a function to create a function, so to speak. Okay, so what have we learned today? We have learned that you shouldn't have too small functions because that renders too much overhead, CPU, memory, etc. Mostly CPU. And instead you can use definitions in the form of function macros. What you do is you define a function-like name, and then you put in parameters like x and y here, and then you show what the substitution should be, because the preprocessor will substitute this for this. And you use the parameters that you defined here. And then you can call this macro like a regular function, supplying arguments. I will tell a small little quirk though. It is okay to do this. Supply an empty argument like this, or an empty parameter. And in this case, and in most cases, this will break our code and generate an error. But in some edge cases, this might be necessary. So just bear in mind that you have the possibility of leaving the parameter blank. Okay, if you like this video, please like and subscribe. There will be more C videos coming up. And also check out the new chat server that will be announced in a little while. So, thanks guys for watching, and thanks for today.